katanas, forged at the bottom of a tartar with the iron sand from ancient rivers around, are a scientific wonder. Katanas needed to be strong enough to hold a sharp edge and flexible enough to receive blows from other katanas. For that, you need the perfect steel. Today, few tatar masters use techniques passed down from many generations before to create katanas. Each katana has its own story, its own history, though some might not be told. Some have their history forever engraved, literally, onto the sword, and some are cursed for the actions they have caused. Today, the Japanese struggle to keep their link with their rich history. A key to this history is the katana, a symbol for honor and power in the time of the samurai. Each handcrafted katana is a masterpiece, taking more than 15 men well over 6 months to create. Though katanas may not have the same uses as they did, they are keys of the past, and an artistic marvel to behold.
...of the furnace, the iron and carbon combine. This process happens at the atomic level. By nature, iron atoms bond to one another in a specific geometric arrangement. When heated, that structure changes form.
Iron actually has two different forms that it takes. A low temperature form, in which the atoms are arranged in a particular way, and a high temperature form, in which they're arranged a little bit differently. There's actually more space between the iron atoms at high temperature.
But when this high temperature form cools quickly, it contracts, and the carbon atoms become trapped in between the iron atoms.
If it does that, the iron can't fully assume the structure that it would like to. It'll be distorted by virtue of the fact that the carbon atoms are lodged into these spaces that are really too small for them to fit into. And that kind of form of steel, iron and carbon mixed together, is very, very hard, very, very strong.
There is really still only one way to learn the art of sword making. Through apprenticeship. No easy career path. They rise at dawn, help with household chores, and work with their master 6 days a week. It takes years to learn correct forging technique. The untreated metal is protected from rusting before the process begins. Heating softens the steel for hammering so that the pieces can be formed into one. The hammering also drives out most of the remaining impurities called slag. Molten slag can be seen in some of the dramatic sparks as it is squeezed out of the steel by the hammering. The steel is pounded flat and then folded time and time again to thoroughly mix the iron and carbon. Gassan gauges the concentration of the carbon by the way the steel bends. How good a job did the ancient blacksmiths do? With modern tools, we can... The samurai needs a sword that is both hard and flexible. But remember that there is a trade-off. Hard metals with more carbon hold an edge, but are brittle and can break. Tough metals bend, but can't hold an edge. Smelting creates pieces of both types, which are then purified and shaped. Now is the crucial moment when both types of steel are forged together. The hard steel is pounded flat and then folded into a U-shape. The tougher, low-carbon steel is heated to a glowing red and inserted into the core. This relatively simple procedure is the culmination of a great deal of work and key to the ultimate success of the sword. Now, the metal the samurai needs is where it is most needed. The hard steel is wrapped around the outside to allow for the cutting edge to be razor sharp. And at the core, where the sword needs to absorb the impact of those deadly blows and be more flexible, Gassan uses the tougher steel.
The sword is...
At Gassan's forge, a much more delicate work is underway. The final stage of the forging process will harden the steel to hold its razor-sharp edge. It is done through a dramatic step of heating and quickly cooling the steel to lock in the carbon. This process, called quenching, will accentuate the hardness of the high-carbon steel, but has little effect on the tough, more flexible, low-carbon steel. Gassan prepares the sword for the dramatic quenching stage by painting on a secret mixture of clay and charcoal powder. This will insulate parts of the blade, allowing some parts to cool even more quickly than other parts. In time, it will also reveal one of the most unique signatures of the samurai sword. The sword is now ready for this crucial moment. Gassan darkens the forge so that he can judge by the color of the metal exactly when the sword edge has reached 1500 degrees Fahrenheit. Too hot, and the steel might crack. Too cold, and the quenching would fail.
The most critical time in the whole sequence is this quenching operation.
Gassan is ready to pull the sword at a moment's notice.
When the smith plunges it into water, the two different parts of the sword are both contracting. The part with low carbon, this is the part inside the core of the blade, is able to contract pretty much like it would like to, because there's really not much carbon in there to be trapped. So it shrinks a lot. The part on the outer surface, though, is filled with carbon, and so it's really prevented from shrinking as much as it would like to. So
the two types of steel contracting at different rates forces the blade to curve, giving the samurai sword its distinctive body-hugging shape. He will spend several weeks bringing the forged steel to a brilliant luster. It takes a lifetime to master this trade. Even learning how to sit isn't easy. Hanami's polishing stones are rare and can cost $1,000 or more. After 10 days of polishing, he moves on to one of the finest stones, the Jizuya. So small, it is sometimes no bigger than a grain of rice.
Katana is very sharp. When I was younger, I used to cut myself a lot. Even these days, I'm still very nervous.
It is only through his intensive polishing but the full beauty of the sword is achieved. And a hidden beauty is revealed. Just before quenching, clay was painted onto the blade. Only now can the full effect of this be seen. Embedded in the steel is a visible line called the hamon. This wavy line is considered a great art form and is created by the skillful manipulation of the steel's inner structure.
The katana is a great masterpiece. Whether new or old, it is definitely not something that should be taken lightly. For many generations, this art form has been passed down to keep the gate of the past open.